it's getting a little scary in the skies. Two more air disasters this week, one in Taiwan and one in Mali, both flying in bad weather. And, of course, those tragedies coming right on the heels of the plane shot down while flying over the war zone in Ukraine. About that, one pilot telling me the following.
Unfortunately, these days, everything is about money. And obviously, airlines are trying to shave off a few minutes of the flight time and save some fuel by going the shortest distance between two flights that happened to be over a war zone.
Wow. And Sabrina, that guy knows what he's talking about. So are airlines putting money over safety?
Well, I don't really think it's quite that simple. Look, I was just in Savannah. I had to be diverted around a big storm. It took an extra half an hour, but of course the airline was concerned about our safety. The same thing last night. My husband flew from Charlotte to D.C. Same problem, storms. They went around. They made a point to share that with everybody. I think that what's interesting is that it's not simply dollars versus safety, right? I just learned about a mathematical modeling company that considers all of the many, many variables that a company like the airlines have to take into consideration. It's a lot more complicated than I think the pilot was suggesting.
Well, although EMAC, again, this pilot does know what he's talking about. He was talking primarily about foreign airlines. And foreign airlines, the pilots don't have the discretion. They have to follow the flight plans, even if it takes them over war zones. They can't change it. U.S. pilots can call an audible and say, I'm going to change it based
on
whatever.
That's a good point. That's a great point. I mean, U.S. airlines, if they crash, that will demolish their bottom line. U.S. airlines are really heavily regulated. But overseas, for God's sakes, we lost an entire airplane, you know, the Malaysian jet. By the way, I missed the memo the Bermuda Triangle got bigger. Who knew? That tells you that the policing of air safety overseas is kind of fragile.
So, Bill, the bottom line is, should we just avoid foreign carriers?
I wouldn't go that far. Now, overall, nationally or internationally, airline fatalities are half of what they were 40 years ago. Volume of traffic is way up. I don't think they're cutting corners.
True, but Rick, when you hear from pilots who say that, you know, foreign airlines have to go on a route, even if the pilot thinks it's unsafe, I'm thinking I'm sticking with U.S. carriers.
Well, you know what? I think we all like U.S. carriers, but you got to look at the numbers and be fair here. When you're flying in North America and Europe, one in 25 million chance of going down. That means 60 years every day and never have a problem.
But John, look at a map. There are travel warnings all over the world right now. And again, some of these airlines are forcing pilots to fly over them.
I'm not buying it. I think we always want to listen to what pilots have to say, but the observable reality is that airlines that have planes that crash are very quickly going to go out of business. Malaysia Airlines may not survive this tragedy. So the economic incentives to keep passengers safe are way too large to presume that something like this is actually happening.
All right. I'm still flying U.S. carriers, folks. Coming up, America's